Hello everyone, welcome to my presentation at the workshop on Emerging Computing Paradigms and Context in Business Process Management of CISOGIT 20. Myself Shreya Ghosh, I am a PhD scholar of the Department of Computer Science and Engineering of Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur. And today I am presenting on behalf of my co-authors Jaydeep Dash, Professor Somakanti Ghosh and Professor Rajkumar Bua. The title of our paper is Clover, Context-Aware Cloud Fog-Based Workflow Management Framework for Health Emergency Services. So this is an outline of my today's talk. I'll start with the motivation and objectives, followed by the cloud fog architecture, proposed methodologies, and the experimental evaluations. So with the major development of sensor technologies and advancements of the communication network infrastructures, there is a growing interest to add more intelligence in the e-health monitoring for facilitating an effective healthcare system. While IoT devices are capable of continuous location and health parameter sensing and providing notifications to the user, an effective business process management, that is BPM, facilitates effective system integration and data processing workflow. This paper proposes an efficient framework for managing emergency situations, specifically health-related, through the analysis of heterogeneous data sources. Specifically, the proposed framework will be beneficial for transport industry, assisting in any time-critical applications or emergency situations, and healthcare sectors. So, with the pervasive use of GPS-equipped smart devices, improved sensor and internet technologies, there is a dramatic revolution in our individuals' daily lives. So to analyze this huge volume of data, computational and the storage power is necessary. However, the cloud-only setup is not an energy-efficient and delay-aware solution for handling such a huge volume of data. To address this problem, edge and fog computing have been introduced. Now, this cloud-fog edge-based infrastructure enhance the functionality of such IoT applications in terms of reduced energy and power consumption and definitely the delay of the processing. Now, this emerging cloud fog edge and IoT paradigms have become a key enabler of effective business processes, including better resource planning and management, customer satisfaction by providing on-time service. For instance, if the band or the body area network can sense abnormal health conditions of an user, it can trigger alert and may help in taking early preventive measures. Further, other disasters or emergency situations such as a fire, traffic blockades, flight cancellations can be managed very efficiently. In brief, IoT devices facilitate continuous monitoring of events through devices like smartphones, wearable devices, or sensors, and cloud fog edge IoT devices provide the computational and the storage infrastructure to provision on-demand services. So, in brief, this technology has the potential to change the current business trends, and the enterprises are increasingly adapting such IoT-based framework in their business workflow. On the other hand, another key challenging aspect is the orchestration and the manageability of these disparate heterogeneous systems or data instances. Like the agency has to be worked together. For example, while providing support to an ailing person, the ambulance service, the healthcare centers, and the city traffic need to seamlessly interact to provide an efficient healthcare service. In such scenarios, the real-time data needs to be analyzed, and several business agencies need to cooperate for efficient service and cost savings strategies. Along with the mobility analysis, the IoT healthcare market actually can grow rapidly for rising demands of improved healthcare with reduced cost and delay, and definitely for providing a reliable connectivity. In this paper, we have proposed an end-to-end workflow management framework, which is named as Clover, to provide a delay-aware, effective, personalized healthcare services to the user. So the key contributions of this work are summarized here. So we have provisioned a hierarchical framework consisting cloud, fog, and edge layers. The framework has been implemented and tested over real-life data samples, and promising results have been achieved. Next, the automated workflow is also useful in taking decisions when any emergency situation arises. We have also proposed a novel Markov chain-based mobility analysis for predicting the routes in the time of emergency. And in summary, in this direction, Clover is a well-designed integrated framework, and it is the first work to integrate several business partners or agents such as hospital, car, IoT devices, cloud data centers, and analyze location information, contextual data, and health information for recommending users' health status and subsequently taking preventive measures. So to the best of our knowledge, no other existing works have been considered such a workflow-oriented data analysis for building an efficient health monitoring system. The figure illustrates the hierarchical framework of the health monitoring and recommendation system. The proposed system architecture consists of users with wearable devices, the handheld devices, the SSENV, that is a small cell cloud enhanced eNodeB, the RSUs, that is the roadside units, and the cloud servers. The handheld and the wearable devices are equipped with various sensors and applications. Those actually help in capturing health related and movement data. The handheld devices are connected with the network through SSENV in indoors. Here, these handheld devices are edge devices which process the data locally. Similarly, when the user is in move, the vehicle such as the ambulance act as the edge node. These edge devices are connected to fog nodes through RSU when the user is outdoor and through SSENV when the user is indoor. The fog nodes help in computing, storing, and communicating between edge devices and the cloud server. The clouds store and compute, these are utilized to analyze the accumulated huge movement and health information. Besides, the system is also capable to detect abnormal health conditions and notifies to the caregivers accordingly. This is the overall workflow of the proposed framework. Clover accumulates health sensor information and analyzes it. In case abnormal health condition is detected or emergency situations occurred, the user need to reach to the nearby healthcare center in minimum delay to avoid any fatal condition. Along with the ambulance service, another fundamental aspect is to find out the optimal path, that is with less congestion, to traverse the distance in minimal time. Body area network is here used to capture the health data of an user, such as the blood pressure, his body temperature, heart rate, and so on and so forth. The collected health data are sent to the smartphone of the user. The geolocation information of the user, health data, and the contextual data are accumulated inside the smartphone of the user, which forwards it to the fog device under which the user is registered. The fog device performs some preliminary processing on the data before forwarding it to the cloud. In case of health data analysis, a functional model is generated to verify whether the user's health status is normal or not. So in this functional model, the geolocation information, the contextual information such as the humidity, the light intensity, or the temperature of the environment, and health data provided as input. Based on the health and the context information, if any abnormality is detected, then the user is notified through an alert. In this functional model, each of the collected health parameter value is compared with respect to its normal range based on the context data and geolocation information. If the health parameter value falls outside the normal range based on the context data set and the geolocation information, then the predicted output is that the health status is abnormal based on these parameters. In that case, alert message is sent to the user along with the information of the nearby healthcare center. Next, we have also proposed a mobility analysis framework for route prediction. A road network can be easily modeled as a Markov chain, where each state of the Markov chain corresponds to junctions or the nodes, and the transition edge corresponds to connecting roads between a pair of junctions. So this interpretation of the road network is defined as a primal. On the other hand, if we reverse the role of the stress and the junction, then the representation is the dual representation of the road network. Clower basically proposed a data-driven Markov model considering quantitative variables, which helps in defining the dynamic nature of the road traffic. Further, to handle the dynamic nature of the road network, we have decomposed the network road network to avoid the redundant computation. So, to predict the less congested path, we have basically used a Markov chain and probabilistic-based approach here. It may be noted that the shortest path may not be the optimal path always to reach the destination due to the usual high traffic congestion or any other events such as traffic blockage or accident. While Dijkstra algorithm is a traditional shortest path algorithm, for goal-directed path prediction, we have used a variant of the A-star algorithm. The first component is computed from the connection of the edges of the road network, that is the length of edge, average time required to traverse. The next component consists of the road subgraph of the road network, consisting the start and the destination node and the context parameter. So Clower basically considers travel patterns, that is P1 of the subgraph, and the real time traffic events as context while computing the cost functions. For instance, the road segment connecting residential regions and the commercial regions usually have high traffic congestion in particular time slots like 8:30 to 9:30 in the morning. Again, real-time traffic events such as the accident or any road blockage impact the usual traffic flow, which also needs to be incorporated in the cost function. So, as A-star algorithm achieves better performance by using heuristic to guide its search, it's a major challenge to define the heuristic in practical travel routing and path prediction system. The travel pattern is analyzed using the autoregressive integrated moving average, or the ARIMA, to find out probable values of GPS footprints of vehicles in different time slots from the historical movement traces as shown in the equation and the matrix here. So we have executed a path finding algorithm on a MapReduce platform for a first response. So this algorithm shows the basic steps of the procedure. Here, if cost parameter produces the cost to reach one node to another based on the predefined parameters and the heuristics given. Each MapReduce iteration advances to extract the optimal path by one hop, and multiple iterations explore the whole graph. Basically, more reachable nodes are included with subsequent iterations as the search expands. To depict the performance of Clower in terms of power consumption and delay, we have theoretically modeled the interconnection of CloudFog edge IoT devices. The delay in health data transmission using SSENV in indoor region is calculated as a function of data transmission amount in uplink and downlink, and the data transmission rates and the failure rates. We have calculated the delay for preliminary processing of health status in the SSENV as well here. Similarly, the energy consumption of the IoT, that is a mobile device and sensors, during transmission is computed as a function of the data transmission amount in the uplink and the downlinks, and the data transmission rates and the failure rates. In a similar way, the delay and the power consumption in the outdoor region is computed following the same formulations. To validate the proposed approach, a testbed has been built, which consists of handheld device, wearable sensor, which collects health and movement data, fog device, and a cloud server. We have used a Google Cloud platform for the computation and storage of huge amount of movement and health logs. The datasets have been collected from individuals of different age at IIT Kharagpur, India region, volunteered. A total of 65 subjects participated in the survey for 6 months. The subjects were requested to install the Android application and carry the wearable device for the study period. Fitbit is used for collecting the health data. We have created an Android application which is capable to communicate with a wearable device, onboard sensors of the handheld Android device, and Bluetooth signals from the beacon. The experimental results are illustrated in two broad aspects. The first one is the power consumption and delay, and the second one is the accuracy of path prediction. For measuring delay and power consumptions of the framework, we have taken different samples of data from the experiment, and we have achieved better performance as shown in the figures. Here the figures represent the delay and the energy consumption in outdoor region, where the roadside units are used as a fog device. Clover utilizes Markov predictor for selecting the best route to reach the destination in minimum delay. The regions show promising reduction of delay and energy consumption compared to the existing, that is a cloud-only solution approach, and the results are shown in these figures. The performance of Clover framework for path prediction from source to destination, avoiding traffic congestion, is illustrated here using a precision, recall, and accuracy metrics. To demonstrate the effectiveness, we have segregated the data into different time bins, such as 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and up to 60 minutes. For each of these time bins, we have computed the metrics. So here the first figure shows the precision and recall values for several time bins required to reach the destination from source. It is observed that the Clover has achieved high precision and recall values in the range of 0.83 to 0.93 and 0.84 to 0.956 respectively. The next figure illustrates the accuracy measure of the Pratt prediction model, and we have observed greater than 80% accuracy with all of these time bins. While these values actually represent high accuracy measures along with increasing time bins, our Clover method maintains steady performance overall. These metrics show encouraging results and depict the overall effectiveness of the Clover framework and the methodologies we have proposed. So, in conclusion, the paper has proposed a context-aware workflow framework named Clover for health management. The environmental context, health data, user movement data are collected using IoT devices which are assimilating data inside the smartphones, that is Edge, and send the data to the cloud through a fog device. For the indoors, user SSNB is used as fog device, which performs preliminary processing on the data received from the smartphone. Then as SSNB forwards the data to the cloud, the data analysis is performed by the cloud and the health recommendations are generated. For abnormal health status, an alert is sent to the user's mobile device for emergency care. Clover implements an end-to-end framework where several agencies' partners work together sequentially to provide better service. The experimental analysis has shown that the proposed framework has better precision, recall, and accuracy, as well as the power consumption than the existing schemes. While Clover is a generic framework, in future we will extend it for other domains such as a defense application or agricultural IoT. The proposed framework will act as a foundation of bridging the gap between process management and the IoT data analytics. So these are the references we have used for this work. Finally, I'd like to mention the TCS Research Scholar Program to fund and support this research. And special thanks to all volunteers of IIT Kharagpur to come forward and share their data for conducting this research. If you have any questions or any feedback, please contact us in this email. We'll be happy to hear from you. And thank you so much for listening.